And of course, looking into the time, it is the time that we welcome the Oracle of the Most High. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Pastor M.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks yourself.
Hi, Grace.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We thank God for this day.
Yes.
Let me take this opportunity to greet Pastor M in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Let me greet Minister Nonke. We greet you, Minister, in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Guys, we thank God for your life.
Amen.
May the Lord continue to bless you.
Amen. Yes.
Do a great work.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me take this opportunity as well to greet our beautiful listeners of Star FM, wherever they are, our online viewers. We greet our listeners in their homes, Minister Malungane, in their rooms, in cars, and taxis on the street. We want to say to them, Shalom, Shalom.
Mm-hmm.
May the peace of the Lord be with you wherever you are, and God loves you this morning in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We greet beautiful, beautiful sons and daughters of Fountain of Life. We greet you and we love you. May the Lord continue to keep and bless you. We thank God for their lives. And Minister Malungane, I also want to thank God for the life of Bishop Mbejin, who is my Timothy.
Yes.
And thank God for him. He's always there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's
Amen.
A pillar of my strength and my ministry, together
Amen.
With his family.
Yes.
I honor God for their lives and
Amen.
Bless God for their lives. May the Lord continue to bless them and grant them their heart desires. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to thank God for this day. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Yes.
We shall rejoice and be glad in it. The devil is a crazy liar. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. And we thank God for the honor. We thank God for giving us more chance to live. And also we want to thank God, Pastor M, for this platform.
Yes.
A platform of bringing the word of God to the nations.
Amen.
You know, I always, when I think, I say, thank God for this platform.
Mm.
Yes.
Because this platform, it makes me to fulfill my calling.
Mm.
Yes.
You know, because I it's not about going to church and people come and gather and preach to them.
Mm-hmm.
When I get this opportunity and preach to the world, I have fulfilled my calling.
Amen.
Amen.
From here, if I want, I can just go home and sit. I have already
Amen.
Fulfilled
Amen.
My calling. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because this platform, it affords me with an opportunity to fulfill my calling every morning, every day. And every weekend, hallelujah,
Amen.
To fulfill my calling, because preaching the word, it's my calling.
Amen.
It's not about church gathering. It's not about going to a church structure.
Yes.
But it's here. This is fulfillment to
yes.
me, hallelujah.
Amen.
And I fulfill my calling. And I want to thank God for this platform. And I pray that this platform may exist forever and ever, as long as we get an opportunity to bring the word of God to the nations. And thank you. Thank you so much. Online viewers, may God bless you. We know you are there already. God bless you
Amen.
As you're about to receive to the word of God. I don't know where to start, Pastor M. I don't know where to start, but let's go back to the book of Joshua. You know, I fell in love with the book of Joshua nowadays.
Yes.
Because I go through this book, you know, I go back and read and go back and go up and go down and go back. And it's wonderful to see how God works.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Now, this week, I was meditating upon Joshua chapter 2. It's a beautiful chapter.
Yes.
Joshua chapter 2, remember, it talks about Rahab.
Yes.
The harlot.
Yes.
The faith. You know, sometimes I said, oh my God, because sometimes we don't preach much around Rahab because
yes.
of what it is.
What she was.
Who she was.
Yes.
And so we try to avoid and so on. Hallelujah. But
Amen.
The Spirit of the Lord kept on saying to me, you must say something there. You must say something. The Spirit of the Lord kept on revealing something about the life of Rahab and Joshua chapter 2. If you read your Bible, if you have your Bible, you can read Joshua chapter 2, the whole chapter, verse 1 up to 21. Mm. But I want you to focus on verse 1 and focus also on verse 9 and focus also on verse 10 and verse 11 and verse 12. And I want you to go through those verses. Hallelujah.
Amen.
About the story of Rahab, the Joshua chapter 2. But our topic, Pastor M, this morning is never allow your past history to determine your future.
Hallelujah.
Never allow your past history to determine your future, or your background to determine your future. That's our topic this morning.
Yes.
Hallelujah. When I was looking at the life of Rahab, then the Spirit of the Lord, I said, Lord, I need to get a theme here, because I always preach under the theme.
Yes.
And then the Spirit of the Lord brought several themes, but this one just touched my spirit. And said, never allow your background or your past history to determine your future. And then look at the life of Rahab. But if you can look at verse 1 of Joshua chapter 2, he starts by saying, secretly Joshua, the next morning, Joshua sent the spies to go and spy the land, especially Jericho.
Yes.
And that word which says secretly, I said to myself, you see, sometimes when God has given you a something to do, a vision, sometimes do it so much in secret way. Don't reveal it to anyone. Because not everyone who will be there to support your vision and your dream.
Yes.
So you must be careful who do you reveal your vision, and who to whom you reveal what God wants to do for you. So the Bible says, secretly Joshua chose only two. Hallelujah. He did not tell everybody, but he selected two spies to go and spy the land of Jericho. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it's a special Jericho. That was the next morning. And the Bible says they went, and according to the instructions of Joshua, the two spies, hallelujah, they went to the land of Jericho, and as they entered the land, they were able to enter the land, and they were able to go. And then another interesting part, Pastor M, is that when they entered the land, Jericho was not so bad. It was a very good city with great men and great women, credible men and women in the city. But and the interesting part is when they entered the city, instead of going to all these big houses where there's great men, great women, the Bible says they went to a house of harlots.
Yes.
They went to a house of Rahab. And you ask yourself, why God you choose? Because here there's so many people and well-known great men and great women, well-known people who have a voice in the city, who can convince anybody, who can talk to anybody. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But God, you see, something that came to my mind, Pastor M, is that, you know, when God wants to achieve anything, he can use anyone.
Yes.
It doesn't matter really your background, your past history, where you come from. If God wants to achieve something, he can use anyone. He can use you. He can use me. That is why last time I said I love the characters in the Old Testament, Pastor Noki, because the character in the Old Testament, you know, it's people who are just ordinary men and women who were used by God. And when I look at that, and I said to myself, I can relate to them. I can associate to them.
Yes.
And I said, if God can use them, he can use me too. Hallelujah. Now you see this picture. I love it. Instead of going to these well-known houses, they chose to go to a house of a harlot. And let me tell you just a little bit of background in the house of a harlot. Because of her reputation, because of what she was, because even the type of the business that she was doing, the type of work that she was doing, I want to believe that she was not favorite in the city.
Yes.
She was not favorite in the city.
Yes.
I want to believe that she was the talk of the town in the city. So I want to believe that she was called names in the city. And I want to believe that her reputation, her character was a mess. And I want to believe that there was nothing going well with her. Hallelujah. No one wanted to come closer to her house. And I want to believe that even when the married women and see their men walk around close to the house, they will scream.
Yes.
Say, no, Jesus. You don't go close to that house.
Dad,
go there. Yes. Glory to Jesus. Yeah. And no one wanted to come closer. Yes. My, can I preach now? One wanted to come closer. No one wanted even to come to the house. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because of who she was.
Yes.
Because of her correct reputation.
Yes.
And no one, she was unfavorable.
Yes.
She was unfavorable. No one, most special amongst the women, no one favored her. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Everyone, when they saw her, they pointed at me with a finger. And she's about to take our husband. She's about to take, you understand, our boyfriends and so on because of what was going on. But let me tell you, though there was no one who was favoring her, or she was not in favor of everyone, but God from above chose a house.
Yes.
God from above, the Bible says the two spies, they went to the house of a harlot.
Sure.
They entered them. In other words, God says, I cannot go to any house, but I just want that house. That house that looks rejected. That house that looks neglected. That house that is a talk of the town. That house that where the very same place where the reputation is a mess. I want to go and fix something in that house. And this is what the Spirit say to me. It doesn't matter my background. It doesn't matter my history. It doesn't matter what happened to me yesterday, last month, last year, and 10 years back. It doesn't matter.
Amen.
If God wants to achieve his purpose, he will use anyone.
Amen.
And when I look at her life, Pastor M, I see the unmerited favor of God upon her life.
Amen.
I see the favor. I see the mercy.
Oh,
I see the tender love of God. I see the grace of God upon her life.
Amen.
That how can you choose such a horrible person? How can you choose such a bad person? How can you choose such a person who has got a bad reputation, a bad character in the city and in the township? And prophetically, the Spirit of the Lord said to me, there are people in the townships, people in the city who are about to give up because of what they have happened, what has happened in their lives. And the Spirit of the Lord said to me, don't dare give up.
Amen.
Because God is watching at you. God can still use you.
Amen.
God can still achieve something great in your life or through you. It doesn't matter what it happened to you. Hallelujah. Maybe people, they are talking about you. Maybe people are neglecting you. Maybe your reputation, your character. But I am here to tell somebody that God will choose your house.
Yes.
God will choose your house.
Yes.
Sometimes God will choose your office. You will choose your business. Will choose your house. Where people think that you are nothing, but to God you are something.
Amen.
And God can achieve great and mighty things through you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I want you to look at this. And God chose to go to the house of this hallowed, hallelujah,
amen,
prostitute, let's put it that way,
yes,
prostitute of the day. Mm-hmm. And God chose that I'm going there, mm-hmm, because there's some stuff that I need to fix in that house. There's some stuff that I need to fix in that business. Mm-hmm. Some stuff that I need to fix in that office. Mm-hmm. Some stuff that I need to fix in that ministry.
Amen.
I am going there. I know that that house, I know that that office, I know that that ministry, it's not favorable in the city, but I am going there.
Amen.
It's where you are going to find me.
Amen.
It's where I am going. And the Bible says the two spies, they went to the house of a harlot. And a house, Pastor M, it was built in a such a way because of her reputation. The Bible says that it was also even against the wall.
Mm. Mm.
In other words, she was pushed a little bit far from everybody.
Yes.
My. It was, her house was used even to support the whole of the city,
mm,
the fence of the city.
Yes.
Just imagine a woman just pushed at the far corner,
yes,
because of your character.
Mm.
But does it matter where you are pushed at?
Mm.
Whether maybe you are pushed at the far corner, mm, God is coming there.
Amen.
God is about to visit,
amen,
you right at the far corner,
yes,
where you are pushed at, in the name of Jesus. And the Bible says the two spies, they went there. When they got the glory to Jesus, and listen to this beautiful, when they got there, she welcomed them. She had so much faith. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Doesn't matter where she comes from, the background. But she had so much, she welcomed, mm, them. There are profound words that she said to Minister Maluga.
Yes.
She said, come in. She said, listen to this. Number one, I know. Number two, we have heard.
Mm.
Glory to Jesus.
Mm.
She said, number one, I know that your God has given you this land.
Mm.
Number two, she said, we have heard about the what your God has done.
Mm.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
And something said to my spirit, you know why? Sometimes when you have the struggles in your life, the enemy knows already what is in for you.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Because this woman, she was from the side of the enemy.
Mm. Mm.
Now, she knew, she said, we know, not only, she said, the enemy knows that the Lord has already given you. Sometimes, Minister Malunga, we struggle on the promises of God when they are not fulfilled. But I want to tell you, even your enemy knows what it's in for you.
Amen.
Your enemy already knows what it's in for you, what God has already reserved for you. She said, we know and we have heard of what your God has done, and God has already given to you. You know, we thank God that it takes a hidden, somebody who's not going to church,
mm,
to confirm the promises of God upon our lives. It takes somebody who is even far outside the house to confirm what God is about to do in your life. And I'm here this morning to tell somebody that you don't have to give up in life,
mm,
because God has something even your enemy knows.
Amen.
That is why you will have so much struggle, because your enemy knows what God is in for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And listen to this. The reason why Jericho was tightened up, they tightened up the screw, it's because of they've heard already,
mm-hmm,
that God has given them.
Mm-hmm.
So the enemy didn't want to let it go.
Amen.
The enemy didn't want to release it,
mm-hmm,
because God has already. So the enemy will try to do something to frustrate you,
mm-hmm,
because God, he knows that God has already given to you.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but in spite of what the enemy is doing, if God has already given to you, he has given to you.
Amen.
It belongs to you. It will be yours. Then she said, we have heard, we have seen that God has given to you. Please, now she made a plea. Listen to this. That please, when the time comes, please do me a great favor.
Mm.
I want you to make sure that you spare the life of my father's house.
Mm.
my father, my mother, my siblings, everybody, please, can you promise and make a vow? That was an intercession prayer.
Amen.
The power of prayer that changed the whole house. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
She interceded from her position of hallowed.
Mm. Sure.
Glory to Jesus.
Yes.
My. She interceded and God had heard the prayer of a hallowed.
Yes.
Yes.
And God promised a hallowed. And I want to believe that, you know, that immediately when the spy went in, and she went to the house with them. Yes, when she went in as a hallowed.
Mm.
But through the conversation, already when she came out of the house, she was no longer a hallowed. She was now a child of God.
Amen.
She was now delivered from her works.
Amen.
She was now delivered from whatever that was following her.
Mm.
She was now delivered from her reputation.
Amen.
Why? Because the God that we serve, he specializes in rehabilitation of reputation.
Amen.
Can I repeat it?
Yes.
The God that we serve,
yes,
he specializes in rehabilitation of reputation.
Amen.
So it doesn't matter what is your reputation,
yes,
in the city. It doesn't matter what is your reputation in the country.
Mm.
The God that we serve, he specializes in rehabilitation of reputation.
Amen.
Meaning that he can rehabilitate my reputation.
Mm.
He can rehabilitate your reputation.
Mm.
He is able, he specializes in rehabilitation.
Amen.
Whatever that needs to be rehabilitated, Minister Malungani,
yes,
God is there to do it.
Amen.
Whether it's business, whether it's work, whether it's finances, whether it's health, whether it's work, God specializes in that.
Amen.
He will be able to rehabilitate you.
Amen.
He will be able to rehabilitate your life.
Mm.
He will be able to rehabilitate your business.
Mm.
He will be able to rehabilitate anything.
Mm.
And when she came in, she was in health. But through that, after when they went out, she was already rehabilitated.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then they made the promises and the vows, as you know the story.
Yes.
That you must put this cord. This is going to be the vow.
Mm.
The symbol of deliverance. The same symbol that you have assisted with us. The destined connectors, destined helpers.
Yes.
The same symbol, the same cord. We are going to follow the same.
Yes.
And we are going to deliver. But provided everybody will be found in the house.
Yes.
My, I wish I was in the church and begin to preach that stay in the house, because if you get out of the house, you are in danger.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
And then provided you will be found in the house. And because they said, well, anyone who will be found outside the house, his blood will never be called upon our hands.
Yes.
But anyone who will be in the house,
My,
it is important, Pastor M, to stay in the house.
Yes.
Because there in the house there is blessing.
Amen.
There in the house there is God's presence.
Mm.
There in the house there is God's movement.
Amen.
There in the house there is God's power.
Mm.
There in the house there is the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So rather stay in the house. And they said, anyone who will be in the house shall be saved. But anyone who will be found outside, his blood will never be called upon us. To cut a long story short, Pastor M, listen to me. As I said, never let your background, never let your past history to determine your future. Let me tell you, if Rahab had let all what was happening to her determine her future, she was going to be nowhere. You see, when we read about Rahab, it does not end up in Joshua chapter 2.
Mm.
Because of her faith, because she did not let whatever the disadvantage to hold her back. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The talks, the criticisms.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The gossips. Because you see, people, they can gossip you. They can tear you apart.
Mm.
They can destroy you. But she did not listen to those.
Mm.
But she had the focus and not to let her background determine her future. So that is why we don't read about it only in chapter 2 of Joshua. When we go to the gospel, when you go to Matthew chapter 1, what do you have?
Yes.
You have her in the lineage of
Jesus.
She is there from a gentlewoman, from an enemy of Israel. Now she's part of the history of Israel. Glory to Jesus.
Yes.
Because the Bible says after some time, Solomon got married to And he got married to his wife, Rahab, and they gave birth to Boaz. Hallelujah. Yes. And Boaz gave birth to Obed. And yes. Obed gave birth to Jesse. And Jesse gave birth to David. Yes. Glory to Jesus. Yes. So this is the lineage of Jesus. But it does not end up there. As I conclude, Minister Nonka, I want you to shout amen to this.
Yes.
It does not end up there. When you go to Hebrews, in the Hall of Faith, chapter 11, only two women are mentioned in the Hall of Faith. It's Sarah and Rahab.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Only two.
Sure.
The rest were men.
My time is up.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Bless you.
May the Lord bless you. Never let your past background and history to determine your future.
Amen.
God bless you. Get in touch with me. 071-622-1868. God bless you. Thank
bless
you.
Amen.
Bless you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.